Hello friends, welcome to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you had a great time this week. So let's begin the weekend having a look at four new SpaceX updates. We'll start where SpaceX is delivering propellant to Starbase, followed by Federal's verdicts in the Blue Origin lawsuit. We'll then discuss NASA's delivery of DART asteroid impact spacecraft to SpaceX, and we'll end with SpaceX's new contract of launching Skynet. Before we dig into the details, we're excited to let you know that we've launched our new channel, Defense Today, to cater your latest updates about U.S. defense programs and some global movements as well. Check the link description below to give it a look and please subscribe. Let's begin with a good update, where SpaceX is delivering loads of propellant to Starbase for Starship's orbital launch site. SpaceX is having a good going with their orbital launch site. As preparations for first orbital flight in the future, they're working on deliveries of propellant, oxidizer, and coolant to the orbital tank farm to make it ready for use during Starship launch. And giving a good boost to the Starbase progression, SpaceX has already started filling their orbital tank farm with propellant fuel. This procedure started less than a year after the beginning of its construction. SpaceX has started cryogenic deliveries of liquid nitrogen to the orbital tank farm in September. They've completed installation of propellant storage tanks by the middle of October. Then plumbing works were going on then, side by side of the cryogenic deliveries. Report says that from mid-September to mid-October, about 40 to 60 tanker trucks have come to Starbase with cryogenic deliveries. Later it was seen that SpaceX teams have piped liquid nitrogen into two liquid oxygen tanks, effectively carrying out the cryo-proof test of these tanks. On the 17th of October, SpaceX started getting liquid oxygen for the orbital tank farm, and it went almost regular. Recent updates of early November state that they've already delivered 74 liquid oxygen tankers to the orbital tank farm, which is nearly 3 weeks from the beginning of oxygen deliveries. Thus, this really proves the pace of SpaceX propellant deliveries. This has also marked the first propellant delivery for tank farm, as early deliveries were mostly of liquid nitrogen. From the regulations of the Department of Transportation, it's estimated that SpaceX has got nearly 1,500 tons of liquid oxygen in 74 tanker deliveries, providing that each tanker has delivered nearly 20 tons of liquid oxygen. Report says that this much amount can easily fill up almost 80% of one of the liquid oxygen tanks. SpaceX deliveries were seen at an average rate of 4.3 per day. Though having such a good speed, it seems that SpaceX will almost need a period of 120 days to completely fill up the orbital tank farm if all the deliveries head for it. Thus, this will be one of the most time-consuming processes, and we hope SpaceX will plan something to cut down the time. Already, they've plans for direct pipelines between the production plant and tank farm. Let's move to our next update, where the U.S. federal court verdict is in NASA and SpaceX's favor. The U.S. Court of Federal Claims is in support of NASA's decision to award SpaceX the contract of the moon lander. Even after Blue Origin's lawsuit, the federal's verdict is going to put a full stop to the delay, which resulted due to Blue Origin's protests. Specific details of the decision, however, are not to be disclosed. As we know, the protests were filed with the U.S. Government Accountability Office, or GAO, as soon as NASA granted the deal of building the human landing system to SpaceX. Blue Origin and Dynetics, the two competitors of SpaceX, chose to file a lawsuit against both NASA and SpaceX, which ultimately led to a delay of months. After the redacted protests at GAO, which were nothing but a sequence of baseless as well as controversial arguments against SpaceX, both Blue Origin and Dynetics didn't handle their losses very well. Majority allegations and arguments of both the protests were discouraged by the GAO. This was the moment when Blue Origin decided to take the matter to the federal court. In the meantime, before GAO disclosed the ultimate verdicts, Blue Origin continuously tried to create problematic situations for NASA. The company tried to win the members of Congress on sympathetic grounds in order to make such amendments that would have forced NASA to alternate its decisions of giving the contract to SpaceX. Jeff Bezos, the owner of Blue Origin, sent a letter to NASA offering a deal at $2 million of the $6 billion which it requested for the development of the moon lander. However, SpaceX worked exactly in accordance with the procedures. Blue Origin's aim was to milk money out of the deal. The company was under the wrong impression that NASA would negotiate the deal for a lower amount. As we know, later it was discovered how Blue Origin eradicated most of the arguments from its filings, which it presented in the GAO protests. The company went on claiming some other minor cases of violations of rules by NASA and SpaceX, and those were the entire basis of the lawsuit. Now there's no confusion that the jury was not convinced by the entire act led by the arguments. On the other hand, the verdict is completely in SpaceX and NASA's favor. It's expected that the final decision will be released around November 18th. It'll be finally clear whether Blue Origin's arguments left any impact on the judge at all or not. For now, we still don't know after how long NASA and SpaceX will get back to work on the landing system. Our next update is based on NASA's delivery of DART asteroid impact spacecraft to SpaceX. NASA has recently announced that their double asteroid redirect test spacecraft, known as DART, has been delivered and received at SpaceX's Vandenberg Space Force Base facility. Launch of this 690-kilogram spacecraft atop a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket is scheduled on the 23rd of November, Pacific Standard Time. SpaceX is using flight-proven Falcon 9 booster B-1063 for this mission. Report says after launch, booster B-1063 will land on the drone ship, Of Course I Still Love You. DART will mark the first interplanetary launch of Falcon 9. It will also lead to the first interplanetary NASA payload launched on a flight-proven commercial rocket. NASA tweeted the future of the DART mission. They wrote, "DART will crash into a small asteroid 6.5 million miles from Earth and measure the effect on its motion." On the 29th of September, NASA had packed and shipped the spacecraft from Maryland's Johns Hopkins University Applied Physics Lab. By the 2nd of October, DART spacecraft had arrived at AstroTech's processing facility of Vandenberg Space Force Base. In the facility, DART was unpacked, then a number of works were carried out on it, its batteries were charged, and several tests were done for final checks. By the 26th of October, the DART spacecraft was preparing for transporting it to SpaceX's Payload Processing Facilities, PPF. Now, as DART has arrived at the SpaceX facility, it's expected that DART will be fueled with propellants for its attitude control thrusters and main ion thrusters propulsion system. All the launch prior works will be done on the spacecraft to prepare it for launch. Report says that nearly a week before the scheduled launch date, SpaceX will encapsulate DART along a Lycia cube small sat made in Italy inside the payload fairing of SpaceX workhorse Falcon 9. According to some reports, by the 16th of November, SpaceX will complete a pre-launch wet dress rehearsal and static fire test of the Falcon 9. After the test, in the hangar, SpaceX will install its payload fairing with DART placed inside. Then they will again roll out the rocket to pad days before launch. Now our last update, where SpaceX has won a new contract for launching the Skynet. SpaceX has won a new contract where it will launch Skynet on a Falcon 9 rocket in 2025. Skynet will be the 15th satellite launch since 1969 that will be carried by the Falcon 9 to a geostationary transfer orbit. The UK selected Airbus Space to build Skynet 6A. Formerly, it was built by British Aerospace, EADS, Astrium, and Marconi Space from 1974 to 2012. European Aeronautic Defense and Space, EADS, founded the Airbus Defense and Space in 2014 in order to combine the Airbus Defense, Astrium, and Cassidian together into a single working unit. At launch, the satellite will weigh around 5,000 kilograms. Falcon 9 is expected to place it into around a 300 kilometer by 35,000 kilometer geostationary transfer orbit. The production contract was granted by the UK in 2020, and the manufacturing of Skynet 6A was started by Airbus in October 2021. According to Airbus, the vessel is on track in order to be launched in 2025. That's all for today, and oh yes, please don't forget to visit our new channel, Defense Today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.